Now, let us move on to some important compounds of carbon. So, one is ethanol and one more is ethanoic acid. There are no doubt there are millions of carbon compounds that are useful to us, but these are the basic ones which we are going to study today. So, let's write the structure of these. Ethanol says that it has two carbon atoms. So, we'll draw the two carbon atoms first. C, single bond C. We have ethanol here. So, what do you mean by OL? That OH group is present. Now, let us fill the valencies. H, H, H. So, now you can also write it as CH3, CH2, OH. So this is ethanol. So now let's just write the structure of ethanoic acid. C and single bond C. It has a oic acid as suffix. So we know that it is a carboxylic acid. So the structure of carboxylic acid is actually like this. And let's fill the valency. You can also write it as CH3 COOH. So this is ethanoic acid and this is ethanol. Now let's study one by one their physical properties and chemical properties. So ethanol is the first compound that we are going to study. So let's look into the physical properties. It is commonly known as ethyl alcohol, students. So it is an alcohol and it contains two carbon atoms. You already know that. And it is a liquid at room temperature. Here is the bottles that we get ethanol in. In labs, we get ethanol in a brown bottle, and boiling point of ethanol is 78.37 degrees Celsius. Why is this important? Because you can see if you keep ethanol as it is, you see that it evaporates very easily. It is very easily evaporated. And it has a boiling point less than water. What is the boiling point of water, student? It is 100 degrees Celsius. 100 degrees Celsius. And the melting point of ethanol is very low. That is negative. That is minus 114.1 degrees Celsius. This is the melting point of ethanol. So the melting point of water is 0 degrees Celsius. You can see the both melting and boiling point is less than water in case of ethanol. So why is ethanol so important? We will see.
Give your imagination wings. If you are willing to write something, what are you waiting for? Share your ideas and thoughts. Let your ideas reach out to millions. Get your articles published through our blogs for free.
Ethanol is used in alcoholic beverages and it is consumed in small quantities with dilution because small quantities of absolute alcohol, that is 100% alcohol, 100% alcohol or 99% alcohol. It is, if you consume it even in small quantities, it might lead to death. So it is consumed very less quantity and it is diluted. Okay. And continuous consumption of these dilute quantities can lead to many health complications. And also in ethanol, we use it in medicines such as cough syrups and tincture iodine and many tonics. We use ethanol as the medicine. And one thing which your textbook does not have, see, NCERT books does not have, is the recent use of hand sanitizers. It is mainly ethanol students. You might see the ads that it contains alcohol. So which alcohol does it contain? It should either contain methanol or ethanol. Because methanol is harmful than ethanol, it is purely ethyl alcohol. The hand sanitizers which you use is ethyl alcohol, but it is denatured, so you cannot drink it. Please don't try it at home. And small amount of consumption of methanol also can lead to death. Now let us see the chemical reactions of ethanol. So ethanol reacts with sodium. You can see here, ethanol reacts with sodium to form sodium ethoxide. So sodium ethoxide and half hydrogen gas. So this is a simple chemical reaction. What is happening here? Sodium is getting replaced. What type of reaction it became? It became a substitution reaction. Sodium is replacing one hydrogen atom. So you can see it gains a plus charge, that is positive charge. Also, you can see alcohol is converted to unsaturated hydrocarbon. So let's see this particular reaction. We use ethanol again. We use hot concentrated H2SO4. So what is H2SO4? H2SO4 is sulfuric acid. And how hot is it? It is 443 degrees Kelvin. So when you heat ethanol to that point, ethene and H2O are the products. So how do you get this particular reaction? You can see here, we'll draw ethanol again. And we know OH. Okay. And there are three hydrogen atoms in the first carbon and two hydrogen atoms in the second carbon. So what is H2SO4 doing? It is a dehydrating atom. So it removes one molecule of water, students. You can see here, we will remove this particular molecule of water. So it comes as H2O. Now this particular carbon has a valency here, which this so this hydrogen comes and attaches here. Now these both have one valency. As it cannot find any hydrogen around, it forms a new bond between themselves. This is how we get ethene. That is unsaturated hydrocarbon. So ethene or many such hydrocarbons has their own particular use. So to make double bonds, alcohol is used and heated with a dehydrating agent. Dehydrating agent means that it should remove a water molecule from a compound, that is one O and two hydrogen molecules. Now let us move on to the next compound, so known as ethanoic acid. If I tell ethanoic acid, you probably might not figure it out, or you might get confused. But if I tell vinegar, you will definitely understand. So vinegar is nothing but ethanoic acid. It is commonly known as acetic acid. The common name of ethanoic acid is acetic acid. You know the properties of vinegar. It is liquid at room temperature, students, isn't it? And its boiling point is pretty high. It is 117.9 degrees Celsius. It is greater than that of water. and also the melting point of acetic acid is greater than water, which is water has the melting point of 0 degree Celsius. Acetic acid has 16.6 degree Celsius. That's why the concentrated forms of acetic acid is known as glacial acetic acid, because in the cold countries, if the temperature goes up to 14-15 degree Celsius, it would start to solidify. So it would look like a cloudy substance. So it got its name glacial acetic acid. And acetic acid is not a strong acid such as HCl and H2SO4, HNO3. These are all strong acids. But acetic acid is a weak acid. It is not as strong as HCl, H2SO4 and HNO3. And also the uses you can see here. It is used as vinegar. I already told you some 5 to 8% of the solution with water. If you add acetic acid, it becomes vinegar. Very simple story. And it is used in lot of chemical reactions. As you study organic chemistry, you can find acetic acid everywhere. And it is used to start a reaction too sometimes. So acetic acid is a very important compound.
Register today at KLM Institute for free online classes, revisions, doubt clearance, private online and offline classes, Olympiad exams, and win prizes, scholarships, and much more.
So let us see the chemical reactions that acetic acid or ethanoic acid goes through. We will take acetic acid and ethanol, that is ethyl alcohol. Ethanoic acid and ethyl alcohol forms a compound known as ester. So why do we get ester and what is ester? Ester is a compound that smells really good. Your iodex or jandu balm is an ester. So the compounds that smell good and fruity are known as ester. So ester is a very important compound. You already know the uses of iodex. So this is produced by ethanoic acid and ethanol. You also get a molecule of water. What is happening is this particular reaction is known as condensation. Here, OH group of one compound and H of one compound is reacting and separating out as water. The remaining two fuse together to form ester. Now let us see the second reaction that ethanoic acid or acetic acid undergoes. So if you react acetic acid with a base, strong base such as sodium hydroxide, if you react it with acetic acid, you get sodium acetate, which is a salt of sodium. Sodium salt of acetate. Acetic acid is known as sodium acetate. It also produces water, students. So this is a simple substitution reaction. The H here is substituted by sodium in NaOH. The remainder will form the water molecule. Also, you can see the sodium salt formation in reaction with carbonates and hydrogen carbonates. What is carbonate, student? We'll use sodium carbonate and sodium hydrogen carbonate. So when you react both of it with acetic acid, CH3COOH is the formula for acetic acid, you get sodium salt. Again, you get a sodium salt and water with the release of, here the only thing extra is the release of carbon dioxide. So why is this important, students? So you need the sodium salt in many ways that you won't understand right now, but this is a precursor to huge chemical reactions. So sodium salt and other salts, alkali salts such as sodium, lithium, and so on, are used to form their salts with acetic acid. So ethanoic acid is one such beautiful compound. We studied about their reaction with another very important compound such as ethanol. So these both are very important compounds in carbon industry, such as organic industry. So thank you, students. That was it about carbon and its compound. If you have any doubts, please leave a comment down below, and please subscribe to KLM Institute.